Good morning, students. Welcome to Mobile Application Development Lab. Today we will look into the fifth program of Mobile Application Development Lab, that is counter application. So here the problem statement for the counter application goes like this. Write a program to create an activity with two buttons, that is start and stop. On pressing of the start button, the activity must start the counter by displaying the numbers from 1, and the counter must keep on counting until the stop button is pressed, and we need to display the counter value in the text view controls. This is what the design of our counter application. So here we have a text view, that is counter application. Then this is the text view where we have the counter value before, and once I press with the start button, the counter values needs to be get displayed here. That is like 1, 2, 3. So this is what here in the problem statement we have. Display the counter value in a text view control. So this is what the text view, that is the counter value. And in this section, it needs to increment the counter values. And on pressing of the stop button, it needs to get stopped. So this is what our fifth program we have, that is the counter application. So we will start. Now open your Android Studio, create new project, give empty activity, and even in my previous videos I have explained why we are going to make use of empty activity. And in the my application, since it is counter application, I'm going to give it as a counter. Click finish. Yes, it will take some time for the Gradle build. Until and unless you get everything like a component tree as well as a project tree completely, the build is successful, you should not click on anything. So that is one thing we need to keep in mind. Yes, now our Android workspace is ready. So go to the activity main XML file and we'll start with the design part. So before the hello world will be, usually we will be having this. So since I need a text view, I'm not going to delete that. Instead of that, for the text, I'm going to just whatever it is highlighted here, like hello world, I'm going to delete that and I'm going to give it as a counter application. Okay. And I want to change the corresponding color, the size of that everything, right? So come here, text alignment needs to be center, and if you want all the letters needs to be displayed in the capital letters, make it true. Then select the color. So if I want that in the blue color, I'm going to take that and text size importantly. So I've given it as a 24, and the style will be normal. So just drag and drop wherever you want. Already the constraints has been taken here. So now I need one more text view. This is what the control, that means the counter value needs to be displayed in this text view only. So I'm going to change that as counter value. Okay. And ID I need to change. Why? Because on pressing of start button, the counter value is going to be incremented, right? That means some action is going to be performed in the this particular text view, right? So that's why I'm going to change the ID as value. Okay, or else if you want, you can take it as btn underscore value. Since it is not a button, for the naming convention, I'm going to take it as a txt underscore value. So let it be in a smaller case letters. And obviously I need to change with the text alignment. So center S. Once you change with ID, it will be it will ask for the refractor. So just give with the refractor. And text alignment, I'm going to give it as center. Then text size, so I'm going to give it as 24. I think nothing else we need. So for the counter values to be displayed, just change the color. I think it is enough. And now the important constraint is I need to give the constraints for this to fix the position in the within the activity area. So that is necessary and I am giving this. Okay, then I have two more buttons, that is one is the start button and the another one is the stop button, right? So start button, so just change the text of the start button as start. Okay, and ID obviously you need to, because it is going to perform certain action. So btn underscore start, and it will ask for the refractor. Then I need to give the constraints. Yes, so like this, and you can copy this and paste. So control C, control V. It will be overlapped here only, so you can just drag and drop so that it avoids the time of giving the constraints and all. So give start and stop, and here button stop. Okay, ID need to change. So these are all some of the basic things you need to do with the design part. I hope no doubts in this. So now we will go for the implementation. There is a code for this counter application. See, you can run and can view how it looks. So better I'm going to run this application. And one more thing I wanted to tell you, once if you keep on running the applications, that is a different programs, you may get some error, or else the emulator may not getting started. So at that time you can do this thing where, 1 minute, since I have already started, it is running. I'll show you need to wipe the data in the emulator. Yes, it has been initialized and it takes time. Yes, here you can look at the design, whatever we have done in the design part, that is in the XML part. But on pressing of start or stop, it won't work, since we have not yet written the implementation code for the what are the actions to be performed. That one we have not yet written, right? So that's why it is not performing any action. Meanwhile, I will show what you need to do. See, you click on this, that is whatever the emulator device you are going to get. And in that, go to the AVD manager. You are going to get this screen. And here in the actions, if you do this, wipe data, whatever you have run so far, that is the that output will be stored somewhere, or it is making some amount of storage space. So that is the reason if you just check here, size on the disk is 9.5 GB. Since I have run so many applications till today, it is showing like this. So if this size on disk, if it is keep on increasing, you may get some error in the emulator. So that is not going to start the emulator, or it will be unfortunately it is going to be stopped. So these are all some of the errors you are going to get faced with this. So that's why if you give wipe data, whatever you have done so far, that means not the programs, only the output what you have executed. So that is going to be get deleted. So look at the size on the disk. So I'm going to wipe the data. So I have given wipe data. Do you really want to wipe user files? So yes. See, now I'm left with 2.1 GB. So this is what it was throwing us error, fortunately. So that is what you need to do when you get the error like this, or if your emulator is not properly, it is not going to get start, means you can do this option. Okay. So now we have done with the design part. So now go for the main activity.java. So we already know these are some of the inbuilt we will be having, inbuilt code we will be having, and we know that on create, main activity, it is a class. That means once if we have this class, that is nothing but one thread has been created for Java, right? So now we have the onCreate method. OnCreate method, usually this method is going to be called when the activity is starting. So that's why we need to have this onCreate. And setContentView, this or.layout.activity main means this is what we are establishing the connection between this Java file as well as with the activity main.xml file, right? So that is the reason we have this activity underscore main here. Okay, so now we will start with the code. Enter to the main activity class. So yes, enter to the main activity class. So now I have two buttons. It is of a type button. So just give button, and I have given btn underscore start, btn underscore stop for the buttons for the start and stop in the XML. And now I need to create a Java reference variable or Java variable. So I'm going to give completely as a button start. And button stop. Okay. So these are the two buttons we have. And I have text view also. Generally, whatever we have done so far in the previous examples, we have not given the text view since we were not making use of that. So but here, since the text view, it needs to be get updated with the counter values I need to give. So text view I have here, avoid typing, make use of the suggestions what it is suggesting, and it is a counter, right? So I'm going to give it as a counter text. Okay, or I can make use of counter value. Okay, so in order to maintain a proper naming convention, I'm going to make use of small letter at the beginning, and at the whenever the space required, I have used the capital letter. So counter value. Then since if you want the counter needs to be run, I need to set that counter value to be zero, right? So I'm going to make use of public, since that needs to be accessed throughout this program within a different class. So public int counter value should be initialized to 0 so that our counter value will get started. And public, the counter will be in the running state or else it will be in the not running state, that means in the stopped, right? So that means either the running can be true or it can be false. So public boolean whether the counter is running. If it is running, it is true. If it is not running, the false. So initially we are going to set that to false. So these are all the things we are going to make use of. So that's what we have given here. So now enter into the onCreate method, and in the onCreate method, what I need to give, I need to give the connection, right? So between the main activity.java file and the activity main.xml file. So button, what I have given, button start, that is equal to, we have already done it many times, it is of the type button, find view by id or dot id dot button start. So it is suggesting and it needs to click, right? So button start dot set on click listener, on click of that button, what is the listener, what the activity needs to be. So this, that means whatever the present instance or the current instance it needs to be, and we know that it throws an exception, so it throws us an error, sorry. So now you just right click your mouse button, give show context options, and it will be giving certain options, that is select main, make main activity implements Android view dot view dot on click listener, and this in turn will ask us for the on click method. So just click OK. So this will give, or this will implement view dot on click listener as well as it will give us with the on click method. So similar way you need to do for the button stop also. So on pressing of the stop button, the counter value comes to the stop. That means since it was in the running, that is true. Now it is going to be a false. So button find view by id of r dot id dot button stop. Okay, and you need to perform action only by clicking that. So button stop, set on click listener this. Okay, so this one, and meanwhile the counter value needs to be get updated. So whatever I have given counter value, that is equal to, it is of the form text view, right? So capital T text view, find view by id, since whatever the counter values will be get keep on changing here in this thread, that needs to be get updated even in the UI design. That means I need to have the connection here between the main thread as well as with the UI design, right? So that's why counter value is equal to text view of text view find view by id, that is r dot id dot what I have given txt underscore value. Yes, so this is what we are going to do in the on create method. So now on click off, what needs to be performed, what action need to be taken? So that is what here we are going to write. So public void on click view, since we have two buttons, if v, that is the view, if v dot equals of button start, what needs to be happen? If v dot equals of button start, the counter needs to get start, right? So I'm just giving it as counter start. Okay, I'm creating a method, that is counter start. So I've created the method. Later we will write the implementation for the, once we have given the counter start, what it needs to be happen. Okay, and meanwhile the same thing I'm going to give if, or else if v dot equals of button stop, if I press the button stop, the counter counter needs to get stop, right? So counter stop, I'm creating a method counter stop. Okay, so give the curly braces for our convenience. Yes, so this is done now, right? Now we need to write what need to be happen when the counter start and what need to be happen when the counter stops. So just click here, show context option, create method counter start in main activity. So give that, it will provide us with the counter start. So in the counter start, we know that the counter value will be initialized to 0. So beginning, the counter value will be equal to 0. Then I need to make running is equal to true. Why? Because before I have said that running is equal to false. That means the counter has not yet been in the running state, right? So now make this running state to true. So now the counter has been started. And we need to know, right, whether it is running. So I'm just going to make use of, sorry, in the next line. Okay, system dot out dot println. To know which thread is running, I'm going to make use of this line, and the counter has been started. So I'm going to print a statement that is start, and I need to know which thread, right? So I'm going to give plus thread, and I need to know which thread. So thread, current thread, and I'm going to retrieve the name of the thread. So I will come to know that which thread is currently running. I will explain why we are going to make use of this, which thread is running and all we need to know. Okay, and I'm going to create an object of the class, since yes, it is the right time I think to explain why we are going to make use of threads, or Before, what we have done so far in the previous programs, we were making use of only a single thread, that is the main thread, which is a part of the main activity. But here, concurrently, both threads will be in the running state. One is your counter thread, and the another one is this is the main thread. How means, see, for example, my counter thread will be busy in incrementing the values. But who is going to display in the UI design, or who is going to interact with the UI design, right? So that is what here we have two threads. So one is the counter thread where it will be keep on incrementing the values, and it will be keep on sending the messages from this part. That means from the counter, that is a counter thread, to the main thread. So main thread is going to be interacting with the front end, that is the UI design, so that the counter values are going to be displayed concurrently. If it is keep on incrementing the values like 1, 2, 3, 4, and it will be if it is busy in incrementing the values, and if I don't have any other thread to display, then what is the use of incrementing the counter values, right? At last, when the thread stopped, and when it stopped like from the busy, it is going to be display. So at that time it will be like 10 or 20. So we cannot say that is a counter value. So just it is like a integer value, it is going to be display. So that is the reason we are going to make use of the another thread, that is a my counter thread. For that we are going to create a separate class, that is my counter class, and output from that my counter class, whatever we are going to be get, so that is we are going to be get in the main thread. So in turn it is going to be displayed in the UI design. So this means that both threads will run concurrently. So listen carefully, both threads will run concurrently. So that is what parallelism we can say, or multiple threads in operating system, you might have studied that. So concurrently here both threads are running. One thread, it is busy in incrementing the counter values, and the another thread will be interacting with the UI design, and it will display there. Okay, so here we have two threads. One is the main activity thread, or you are going to call it as a UI thread, where it is responsible for the interaction with the UI design, and it is displaying. And the another one is the counter thread, or we can say that as a my counter thread, that will be keep on incrementing the counter values. So this is what we need to know before doing this program. So now I'm going to create the object of that my counter class. So that is new my counter. So new my counter. So this is the object, and here this my counter will or output from the new my counter you are going to get will be the object. So that is what new my counter, and I want to start that, right? So start, and I'm going to make button start. I am going to make this as set enabled to false. So I will explain why this after once I have started to run. Okay, so once the counter has been started, we need to make that start button to be enabled to false. That means we are disabling that start button, and I am going to enable the stop button. Why? Because that button needs to get enabled so that I can stop with the counter values, right? So I am going to set this stop button enabled to true. So this is what you need to do, and similar way create the method for the counter stop. Show context option, create method counter stop. So yes, enter. And this instance needs to be stopped from the running state. So this dot running, that is equal to false. So once I have make it as a false, I need to enable the button of start to be enabled, right? So button start, I'm going to make it, or I'm going to set enabled to true, right? And the stop button needs to be disabled. So set enabled of false. So this is what we have for the counter stop and the counter stop button. And now this my counter, so just if you mouse over on this, you will get create class my counter. So create class my counter. So the destination package, it is asking, I think it will create, it will not create the inner class. So let me go for the show context options. See, if you just mouse over, you are going to get with create my class. So don't go that, give show context options. Here you have create class my counter, don't give that. That means separate class like my main activity dot java you are going to get. So that is not required. So create inner class my counter, that means within this main activity only we are going to get with the inner class. So this is what here we are going to have. So private class main, that is a my counter, this should not be private obviously, because this needs to be interact with the different thread. So class my counter, so that is going to be extends the thread and give show context options. Create method start, oh not necessary, so it will go off later. So class, and this extends thread, so that is what another way we have to create. Yes, and I need to have the run method in order to run the my counter. So public void run, I'm going to give system.out.println to check that this thread is running. Okay, since it is a my counter thread, I'm going to give it as a my counter, so to check whether it is running. And I'm going to append with which thread, to know which thread is running, right? So thread dot current thread, and I want to retrieve the name of that, so get name. Okay, and this thread while running, while it is in the running state, what needs to be happen? Because if it is running means it will be incrementing the values, but it needs to interact with the main thread, that is the main activity class, right? So in order to send a message, that is from the my counter thread, or my from my counter class to the main activity, or my counter thread to main thread, that is the values, the integer values, the counter values it needs to send. So while it is in the running state, so while running, the counter values needs to get incremented. Okay, so counter plus plus, and we are going to make use of handlers here. So now comes to the handler. Previously I have explained about the thread, so now we need handlers. So handlers are like, it is going to provide a communication channel between two threads. Okay, for example, if I want to communicate with any other person who is far from us, so I'm going to make use of certain media, right, or certain device. So that is not the communication channel for us. So similar way, I have the counter values here in the my counter thread or in the my counter class. So those values, if I want to send from ear to ear to the main thread, so there needs to be certain communication channel, right? So that is going to be provided with the help of the handler. So handler, it is going to provide a communication channel between two threads. So when we create new handler, it is bound to a looper also. So I'm going to make use of handler now. So before the class, I'm going to write handler. So handler is a class. I'm going to create the object of the handler class. So and learn. So when you get the errors, so just go to the show context option, import that class. Okay, so import class, it's enough. That is equal to new handler. So whenever we create this handler class, that is going to be bound to a looper also. So looper dot get main looper. Okay, we need to use this. And so this is going to, this looper or get main looper, why we are going to make use of this, means it will deliver messages or whatever the messages we are going to get in the my counter thread and runnable to that looper's message queue and execute them on that looper thread itself. So that is what you are going to make use of, looper get main looper. This is going to be provided looper instead of the default one. So we are going to make use of this one. So if you mouse over here on the handler or get looper, get looper, so you are going to get with the suggestions or you are going to get with all the informations. So use the provided looper instead of the default one. And if you mouse over your handler, see, allow use to send and process message and runnable objects associated with the threads message queue. And in short, I have already told that it is going to provide us with a communication channel between the two threads. Okay, and so just give this, and I need to override the override the method. So that is public void handle message. So that is a method to handle the message whatever it has been received from the another thread. So I'm going to give it as message. Yes, or you can just import the class for the message. So import class message. Okay, yes. So now counter. So what is the Java reference variable we have given for the counter? It is counter value. So just take that here, counter value, that needs to be displayed, right? That means that is now going to be set the text, and that is a, sorry, set text, and that is a value. So that is going to be converted to the string format, or it is going to display the value of message what it has been received. So what I given, ME, yes. So message dot, see this method what we have, handle message, it is going to take up with the message. And this set text, it is going to take up with the value, that is message followed by what. So what, it is nothing but an integer value it is going to be received. Why we are going to make use of this what here is, in this, so after this counter plus plus here, we are going to send the message from with the help of the handler. So that is what here we are going to make use of, send empty message int what. Int means it is a integer value. What means that exact what. So what value it is sending. So this send empty message method, it is going to send a message containing only the what value. Okay, and it is going to return true if that has been sent with the value properly. So this make use of send empty message of what we have, the values, right, where it has been stored in the counter. So counter, right? So this method, send empty message method, is going to return us with the boolean value. See, look at here, sends a message containing only the what value. So what means here we have the counter, since it has been stored as store the values, counter values, that is going to be send here, and returns true if the message was successfully placed into the message queue, otherwise it is going to return us with a False. That means the counter values will not be sent properly. So that means that it is going to return only the Boolean value, either true or false. So this returns true or false. Okay. So since the counter value, if it is not yet been started properly, or if the counter values has not yet been increased properly or incremented properly, it needs to be surrounded by try and catch blocks, right? So try. I'm going to make the thread to sleep for 1000. That means the gap, the time gap between the counter values, I'm going to make it as 1000. That is 1 second. It is in the form of milliseconds, right? So exceptions needs to be handled. So catch of exception E. Close this. So this is what value, the what value is going to be transferred to here. So that is what we have given here. I think you have got with the execution or the flow of this program. And now since that handler, it is for this only for the my counter thread, I'm going to terminate that here. Okay, so here the overall or the summary of this program is, I need to have the implementation of counter application, that is with the help of the threads and handlers. Here I have a main activity thread. So this is a UI thread also. We can have another name, that is a UI thread. And here we have established the connection between the XML as well as the Java. And on click of button start, the counter needs to get start. And on click of stop button, the counter needs to get stop, right? So we have written a different, the counter start method and the counter stop. So counter start, the counter value will be initialized to zero and the running state will be true. And I want to know the thread which is currently running, so that I am going to make use of this line. And I need to make use of the my counter, that is I'm creating the object of the new class, that is a my counter class, where this my counter thread will be keep on busy in incrementing the values, and it is not bothering about the displaying in the UI design. So this my counter is going to be get start, and meanwhile this two buttons you will come to know when I started to run the application. And we can establish the connection between this my counter class and this main thread, that is a UI thread, with the help of the handlers. So handlers, it is a communication channel between two threads. So when we create a new handler, that is going to be bound to a looper also. So if you look at here, class user to run a message loop for a thread. So that is what looper, get main looper. It will deliver the message and runnables to that looper's message queue and execute them on that looper's thread. So this is what we are going to have. Handlers, so it needs to handle the message what it has been received from the my counter thread. So that is going to be given here with the help of the handle message, and that message, it is a string, it is a value. So message dot what, where what is from the send empty message. So this is going to be taken with int what. So int means integer value, and what means what the values, the counter values. So that is going to be sent with the help of the handler to the another thread, right? So this is what here we have the summary of this program. So it's the time to run the application. I hope you people don't have any doubts, and if you have any queries, just put a message or the message sorry put put your query in the comment section. Subscribe to our channel so that you will get more updates on the Android, as well as we will do more videos very soon. I hope you all like our teaching, and if you have any changes, or if you want to make any changes, or you are expecting more from us, means you can put it in the comment section. Thank you, and we will look at the output here. It is taking time. Soon we will do with the Part B programs also. launch succeeded. It will display. Yes, meanwhile, it has been turned off. Okay, start. The counter values is displaying properly. And if you observe here, see, since I have made this in the counter start, the button start set enabled false. That means once I have started with the start button, that is, it is in the running state, it is going to disable the start button and it is going to enable the stop button. So that's why I have given here, if you observe. So button stop, it is going to be get enabled to true, and button start is going to be get disabled. So that is what here we have, we are going to be shown that. And we'll check, not in the event log, in the run, I think. Yes, if you look at here in the run, see here, I have given this line, no, system.out.println start, and I need to know which thread it is running. So look at here, start main thread, it has, it is running, and in the my counter it is running, it is running thread 2. Okay, okay, it has been stopped. Yes, it is still running, and I'm going to stop that. So once I press with the stop button, the start button is going to be enabled so that you can press with the start button only. And just I'm going to show that I'm going to comment this section, what happens if we didn't give this. Okay, didn't give this, two things. Okay, so now we will run that again. I'm just going to stop this. Observe here in this section, that is run, and I'm going to run this. So observe in the left side of the screen, yes, it is going to launch the activity now while the mobile got turned off. You can switch on here like your mobile phone. So launch succeeded. So look at here, the start button. Yes, see, start main my counter thread 2, and it is already running. And if I didn't make the start button disabled, if I press keep on start, the new threads, look at here, thread 2, it has been started before, and now thread 3. So if I just keep on pressing with start button, so it is going to keep on creating a new thread for the my counter. So this is what it is going to be happen when you set these buttons to get be false. So I hope you all understood. Thank you all. So this is what the counter application. Soon I will come up with the passing of XML and JSON.